What's up, Two Beavers? I just got done wetting my whistle here a little bit. This is my probably 8th or 9th attempt at this video, wasting about 9 or 10 minutes every time, which is pretty sad. But the fact is, I wanted to get this video out to give you guys kind of a little public service announcement, and hopefully instill a little faith back into the YouTube community, because that's 100% what this video is about. Alright, I was talking to Len Ren 2004 today. If you guys don't know him, he's a great guy. We text back and forth a lot, and he said, you know, we were talking about the Melbourne Cowboys incident, and he was like, hey man, yeah, I think it would be a really good idea for you to throw a video up and try to do what you can to try to build the faith back up and to, you know, hopefully build the morale back up in YouTube. And I was like, you know, I don't want to get involved in all the drama, and, you know, the fact of the matter is, I can post this up without getting involved in the drama. So, here we go. I'm going to try to make this as short as possible, but I'm going to get my point across. All right, first off, I'm not going to sit here and try to show evidence on what Melbourne Cowboys did, what Boombox Jesus has done, what UMiami might have done, because that all can go without being said, because it's completely obvious, okay? So just go search around if you have any questions about what I might be talking about. All right, so I know that there are so many people that got screwed over. All right, and a lot of people are pissed. A lot of people are like not wanting to be involved in this community. I mean, we literally have people walking in the YouTube community door to join this community and are seeing all this garbage going on and turning around and walking back out. And that upsets me, guys. And if it doesn't upset you, then I don't know, you know, what your deal might be, but it really upsets me that we could have more people joining our community that are turning around and leaving because we got people like Melbourne Cowboys and Boombox Jesus screwing people out of thousands of dollars and thousands of dollars worth of cards. So, and it's really hard for me to sit here and try to bring a little faith back to you guys and you know, hopefully reassure you guys that this is a great community. But I'm gonna try. All right. For example, I like to refer to a little bit of a clique, I guess you could say, that I'm involved with, like a little suburb of the community, I guess you could say, where we have stuff going on all the time. All right, we got group breaks going on all the time in our little suburb. We got great stuff going on Blog TV all the time, and we have things that are constantly there to make people happy, make people have fun, and enjoy their experience with the YouTube community. So by that I mean, you know, subscriber contests with hilarious video responses, for one. We have Blog TV nights where we're doing, you know, in-hand breaks, group breaks that are all, you know, completely legit. Nobody's ever been screwed over. And then to top it off, we have an award that just got started last week. ARFalcon77 started a great idea called the UROC SuperTuber of the Week. Now this award is given out to one YouTuber a week that, you know, basically it's used to represent that, is used to be given to that person for doing a great job at what they do in YouTube, for doing great group breaks, being a great guy, all that stuff. And I'm not saying that to brag, because, you know, I was the first UROC SuperTuber of the Week, which I'm very, very, you know, happy for that to be the case. But that's not by any means what this video is about. But tomorrow, the next UROC SuperTuber of the Week will be announced, so keep your eyes posted for that. But anyways, all I can really say, guys, is don't give up. Don't give up the faith in the community. Stick around with the right guys. Stick around with the guys that have the good records. I mean, if there's new guys that come about, yeah, you got to give them the light of day. Give them the chance. Let them build themselves up on YouTube. Let them have a good time too. But the fact is, we got to patrol each other, guys. This instance with Melbourne Cowboys could have been caught a long time ago. But the fact is, we all trusted him, and, you know, we thought that it was legit, and we were wrong. And it's hard to recover from something like this. Like, I'm literally upset about this situation because there are so many people that got affected by this, and it's just really, really, like, it makes me so angry. I can't really express it to you guys. But that's neither here nor there, guys. This is like my 10th attempt at making this video. But, you know, basically, like I said, Len Ren 2004 said, you know, go on there, try to instill a little bit of faith back into the community. The best way that I can do that is to say, guys, surround yourselves by people that you would like to be surrounded with, you know, outside of YouTube, you know, at home. Like, I can say that about, you know, I talk to probably 20, 30 people on a daily basis, and that's not to even mention the amount of PMs that I get from you know, new people that I always answer. I'm not the UMiami that just ignores messages from people. All right, I enjoy talking to everybody in this community. And I'm not, okay, let me get off that subject because I'm by no means doing this to promote myself at all. I'm doing this to let you guys know that this is a great community and that we have to help each other in order for this community to prosper. We have to keep an eye out for the scammers. We got to keep an eye out for the, you know, the people that are ripping us off in group breaks. And when it comes about, post up a video, okay? Let people know. And hopefully we can do everything we can to get that video around and prevent all the money that may be lost and cards that may be stolen ahead of time, before it winds up happening. And by no means am I blaming anybody that was involved in Melbourne Cowboys group breaks for not noticing this, because I did not join any of his group breaks, but I am just as guilty because I watched all the videos. And yes, when I first started watching his videos, I was like, why in the world is this guy not showing the cards when he's doing the group breaks? I did say that to myself. And the fact was, I looked at his subscribers, got like, you know, over 600. And then I was like, well, he's on Blog TV, so he must be showing the cards to everybody on Blog TV for this not to be an issue. But he wasn't. So, you guys, if there's any instance where you think that something might not be legit, then call that person out on it. And I don't mean to like post up a rant video before you know the situation. Like, if you're on Blog TV and you can't see the cards, just say, hey man, you know, I'm in this group break and I can't really see the cards. Can you make sure that I can see them? Can you keep the cards above the table? Can you, you know, keep the cards in view of the camera? You guys have every right to do that. Okay, if you posted your money, even if you're in there watching and you're noticing that nobody in there is saying anything about it that paid their money, you know, even if you're in there watching, be like, hey man, I'm not on this group break, but I can't really see the cards, and I'm just sitting here to watch. I kind of want to see what cards are getting, you know, pulled and stuff. Can you make sure that we can see the cards? And if we do that, guys, I think we can avoid 99% of this stuff. All right, the Boombox Jesus thing. That guy's gonna get what's coming to him, just like Melbourne Cowboys. I mean, he scammed people out of a lot of money. And you know, that is such a small percentage of our community, and I wish I could say that that's not going to happen again, but the fact is, guys, that it probably will, because there are dirtbags in this world that once they see our community, they will immediately try to join it and take advantage of us. So so we just got to patrol for each other and try to help each other out. So I hope this kind of builds up the morale a little bit and lets you guys know, don't give up, all right? Do not give up. Post your comments and your thoughts about this video down below. Let me know what you guys think. I hope you guys all take this message and appreciate it for what it's worth. And just one more thing that I wanted to quote real quick, or just to bring up real quick. This isn't, it's kind of a little bit off subject, but UMiami posted up, like, when his little video that started, that was the beginning to all this drama that started, posted up a video that said, you know, you're not doing a group break 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 times a week because you enjoy it. And the fact is, that is completely inaccurate. I would do a group break every single day, twice a day, if I had the time and I had the patience and I had like all the people to join it. I would, guys, I would, because I love breaking the cards. I love packing them up and sending them out to people, writing little notes saying congratulations and all that stuff. You know, I love doing that kind of stuff, guys. And the fact is, if there's anybody that you're involved with that, you know, like UMiami, that will post up a message saying that, then the fact is, he's not the kind of person that should be doing group breaks 2, 3, 4, and he doesn't, which is good, because when he does do them, he overcharges people. But anyways, that's completely off the subject, and I just wanted to say that because it's really been bugging me a lot that comment got posted out there and nothing got said about it. But just let it be known, guys, that my community that and the people that I surround myself with are great guys, and we're doing this for the right reasons. So just surround yourself by people that you are confident that they're doing the same thing, and let's have a blast. Let's weed the bad guys out and, you know, bring new people into this, and let's have a great time, guys. That's what this is all about. So I hope to hear some great thoughts on on your thoughts on this video. Like I said, I hope there's no negative responses to this, because I didn't mean to start any trouble, any drama, whatever in this video, because if you know me, you know I like to stay away from the drama. But also, I feel it's my duty, as because I have, you know, enough subscribers, to post a message like this and let you guys know what I think. So I hope you can appreciate it for what it's worth. I love all you guys in a no homo way. And I look forward to the next time we talk. Talk to you guys later. Peace out.